Greetings. When you go back to how the history of Judaism began, you will no doubt go back to Father Abraham and the covenant God made with Isaac. Genesis 17:19. And God said, Sarah, thy wife, shall bear thee a son indeed, and thou shalt call his name Isaac, and I will establish my covenant with him for an everlasting covenant, and with his seed after him. And you may make mention how God tested Abraham's commitment to the covenant by being willing to sacrifice Isaac. Genesis 22:2. And he, meaning God, said, Take now thy son, thine only son Isaac, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him there for a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell thee of. But be warned, if you mention this fact to someone programmed by Islam, be prepared for the most amazing lie you've ever heard. They will claim Abraham offered Ishmael on the altar. Then be prepared for the accusation. Jews, evil lying Jews, changed the text of the Torah from Ishmael to Isaac. I assure you, I do not make this crap up. I have actually had Mohammedans tell me this very thing. You may even point out other verses that establish who has the covenant, like Genesis 17:15. And God said unto Abraham, As for Sarai, thy wife, thou shalt not call her name Sarai, but Sarah shall her name be, and I will bless her and give thee a son also of her. Yea, I will bless her, and she shall be a mother of nations. Kings of people shall be of her. Then Abraham fell on his face and laughed, and said in his heart, Shall a child be born unto him that is 100 years old? And shall Sarah that is 90 years old bear? And Abraham said unto God, Oh, that Ishmael might live before thee. You see, Ishmael had already been born, and God's talking about another son through Sarah. And Abraham begs God, O God, make your covenant with Ishmael. Oh, that Ishmael might be the one. And God said, Sarah, thy wife, shall bear thee a son indeed. And thou shalt call his name Isaac, and I will establish my covenant with him for an everlasting covenant, and with his seed after him. And as for Ishmael, I have heard thee. So God admits, you know, okay, I understand, Abraham, you love Ishmael, your child that you had with your slave girl, Hagar. I understand, he's precious in your heart too. Behold, I have blessed him, and I will make him fruitful, and will multiply him exceedingly. 12 princes shall he beget, and I will make him a great nation. But, Abraham, so I just said a bunch of nice things about Ishmael. I'm going to make him a great nation, but my covenant will I establish with Isaac, which Sarah shall bear unto thee at this set time in the next year. And notice what I just did. I read the whole passage in context. When you talk with a Mohammedan, they will only ever quote this one verse, Genesis 17:20. And as for Ishmael, I have heard thee. Behold, I have blessed him and will make him fruitful. I will make him a great nation. Then they will try to explain away Genesis 22:2. And it came to pass after these things that God did tempt or test Abraham, and said unto him, Abraham, and he, Abraham, said, Behold, here I am. And he, God, said, Take now thy son, thine only son Isaac, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah. And the excuse they will offer for a reason will be this. See, it says only son. There was only one time when Abraham had an only son, and that was when Ishmael had been born, and before Isaac was born. But essentially, the following is what Mohammedans are willing to believe and want you to believe as well. Number one, the Jews are so evil they have rewritten the Torah to exclude Ishmael. 2. The Jews are so powerful, they are able to rewrite the word of Allah, and Allah is powerless to stop them. 3. Yet the Jews are so stupid, they will change all of the text to give themselves the covenant, to steal it from the Arabs, the rightful descendants of Ishmael, but forget to change the one mention of only son. In order for you to accept the Islamic story, you must believe all these preposterous and idiotic things. If you call yourself Muslim, you must believe all these preposterous and idiotic things. If it wasn't tragic, it would actually be funny that they are willing to make up such garbage. But there is actually a real reason God called Isaac the only son of Abraham. And it seems obvious to me. If God does not make mistakes, if God does not lie, then when God said, "Your only son Isaac," God was speaking the absolute truth. In God's eyes, Isaac was the only legitimate son of Abraham. Remember, O Muslim, this is the message from Prophet Moses, who the Quran says was a prophet of God. Remember, O Muslim, this is written in the Torah, that the Quran says is the word of your Allah. O Muslim, this is the confusion Muhammad's religion causes. But let's review what God said. Genesis 17:15. And God said unto Abraham, "As for Sarai, thy wife, thou shalt not call her name Sarai, but Sarah shall her name be. And I will bless her and give thee a son also of her. Yea, I will bless her, and she shall be a mother of nations. Kings of people shall be of her." God said he would give Abraham a son through Sarah. God even changed her name to be Sarah. God was rather clear on this matter. God would give a son to Abraham using Sarah, his wife. God even repeats himself. Genesis 17:19. And God said, "Sarah, thy wife, shall bear thee a son indeed. And thou shalt call his name Isaac, and I will establish my covenant with him, for an everlasting covenant, and with his seed after him." Notice he said, "Sarah, thy wife." His name is Isaac, and it shall be an everlasting covenant. Everlasting means without end, eternal, forever. O Muslim, if your religion says God's covenant with Isaac has ended, you are calling God a liar. God said his covenant would be everlasting, meaning without end, eternal, forever. O Muslim, if your religion says God's covenant has ended, you are calling God a liar. When you follow Muhammad, you are obeying a person that makes you call God a liar. O Muslim, why do you obey a person that makes you call God a liar? O Muslim, do not call God a liar. And make no mistake, you are calling God a liar. O Muslim, do you worship God or do you worship Muhammad? You say Allah, but then Muhammad makes you call God a liar, and you obey Muhammad. If you obey Muhammad and call God a liar at Muhammad's command, do you really think you could be submitted to God? If you call yourself Muslim and follow Muhammad, ask God to forgive you for calling him a liar, and then stop calling God a liar. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. May the Spirit of God set you free from the darkness of Islam that blinds your eyes. Amen.